Your eyes are different colors.
My left eye sees the past.
And? What about your right eye?
You'd be hard-pressed to find a work of science fiction that wasn't influenced by Blade Runner in some capacity. The aesthetic impact it had on the genre is still felt today, and has met no equal since it first landed in cinemas those long 40 years ago. That universe has nourished countless creatives and driven emulous spirits to dream up their own techno-noir realities of wonder. Shinichiro Watanabe was one of those dreamers. He's called Blade Runner his greatest source of inspiration when developing the world of Cowboy Bebop. So it's appropriate that he would then be the filmmaker chosen to build out the connective tissue between the Blade Runner of the past and the Blade Runner of the present. And now, in a cyclical turn, we see the inspired become the inspiration. Generations of cultural exchange that feed into each other like an Ouroboros of influence. A system of cells interlinked within cells interlinked within cells interlinked within one stem. Different boughs of the same tree.
This blue eye perceives all things conjoined. The past, the future, and the present. Everything flows. And all is connected.
Both Bebop and 2049 share a deep, loving reverence for what came before, but also have a confidence about themselves. A self-assuredness not to let the weight of that respect collapse into pastiche. But as the progeny of Blade Runner, they're both pulling from the same constellation of influences, so that common heritage, of course, leads to a lot of little synchronicities. Some are broader sci-fi concepts that aren't too uncommon in fictional dystopias, like dead cities buried under a junk heap in a ruined earth, with scavenger children from an orphanage embowered in scrap and garbage. And some, a bit more specific, like a devastating incident in the year 2022 that scrubbed all trace of the digital world.
Due to the explosion of the lunar gate, all data encoded before 2022 is missing.
10 days of darkness. Every machine stopped cold. When the lights came back, we were wiped clean.
But these are just the superficial similarities that come with the science fiction territory. The connections that interest me are those concerning human beings. Synthetic or otherwise, lost souls who exist on the fringes, searching for place and purpose. People just trying to piece themselves together from the scattered wreckage of a broken world, asking the same questions all of us are as we march toward the ash heap. Where do I come from? Where am I going? How long have I got? But you strip it all away, and the only thing that truly makes us human is connection.
There was a woman. First time I found someone that was truly alive. At least that's what I thought. She was the part of me I'd lost somewhere along the way.
It's too bad she won't live! But then again, who does?
We're all just looking out for something real. Intentional or not, there's some beautifully poetic symmetry in the last breaths of these two moribund renegades. I can't say for certain how much of these parallels are deliberate, though if they are, I'd hesitate to even call it an homage, really. More like, they share the same soul. A soul that was cradled by Roy Batty in his own final moments, baptized with purpose as he dies in the rain.
I've seen things you people wouldn't believe. Attack ships on fire off the shoulder of Orion. I've watched sea beams glitter in the dark near the Tinhauser Gate. All those moments will be lost in time. Like tears in rain. Time to die.
If you'd like to see more videos like this early and ad-free, I'd encourage you to head over to Nebula. Nebula is a streaming platform that's creator-owned and operated where we can experiment and create exclusive series. One I think you'd be interested in is called Working Titles, a show that explores the creativity in the opening credits of various television series. There's one on Cowboy Bebop by Matt from Extra Credits that you should definitely check out. And when you sign up for Nebula, you also get access to Curiosity Stream, a streaming service that hosts thousands of documentaries and nonfiction content. In fact, while researching for this video, I found a great documentary over there called The Worlds of Philip K. Dick, which takes a deep dive into the many works and adaptations of Dick's work, including Blade Runner. And if you sign up using the link, you'll get 26% off, so you'll get a package deal of Nebula and Curiosity Stream together for less than $15. Plus, on top of getting access to two great services, you'll also be helping out independent creators as well, which is always appreciated. So sign up today by clicking the link or by going to curiositystream.com/kaptainkristian. Thank you for watching, and I'll be seeing you all very soon. Take care.